In this video, we're going to do an example involving the nearest neighbor algorithm and the repetitive nearest neighbor algorithm. So, recall that when you apply the nearest neighbor algorithm, it's not just enough to have a complete weighted graph. You also need to be given some extra information, namely the starting vertex. We need to be told which of these five vertices that we're going to start from, A, B, C, D, or E. Applying the algorithm to different starting vertices could give us different answers, so it's very important that we have to fix a starting vertex. So for the moment, let's start at vertex A. Now here's the intuition for applying the nearest neighbor algorithm. Think of the vertices as representing location. This may not make sense in the context of the problem. Regardless, for the purposes of this algorithm, think of the vertices as representing locations. And think of the edges as representing roads between those locations. And the weights, think of those as the mileage or cost that you would incur by traveling along that road from one location to the next. Now, imagine yourself in a car starting at your starting vertex, which in our case is A. So you're in a car starting at A. You want to produce a Hamilton circuit, namely you want to visit each vertex exactly once and have a circuit when you're done. So from A, we have four places that we can visit. We can go to B, C, D, or E. Now, the nearest neighbor algorithm tells us that from our starting vertex, the next vertex we need to go to is the one which is cheapest to get to. So if we look at our four different options, from A we'd go to B, that would cost us 7. We could go to C, and that would cost us 13. We could go to D, and that would cost us 2. Or we could go to E, and that would cost us 10. So among those four options, we see that the cheapest to get to from A is D. We should go to D next. That would cost us 2. So we draw in that edge in color in D. So think of that as representing that you're actually in your car, you were at A, and now you've driven along that road that had a weight 2, and you've now arrived at D. And now you're in your car at D. And the same issue is, from D, where do we go? We have three places to go, C, B, and E. Which one is the cheapest to get to from D? Well, from D you could go to C, that would cost us 8. You could go to B, and that would cost us 9. Or you could go to E, and that would cost us 11. So the next cheapest place to go is C. There's two locations now to go to, B and E. We look at their respective weights, and we see that the cheapest one to go to is B. That would cost us 3. There's only one vertex we haven't visited, and that's E, so we have to go to E next, and that would cost us 5. And then we want a circuit, so we're forced to go from E back to our original starting vertex, which was A, and that cost us 10. You add all these up to get the total weight, and you should get 28. That Hamilton circuit, A, D, C, B, E, A, that is the circuit that's produced by applying the nearest neighbor algorithm to this graph starting at the vertex A.